match is Are You Still Ready? Our next tag team match is scheduled for a one fall.
All right, tag team action here. Peter DeLong still on the call with you, along with Anthony Blackwell. And these are two teams that have been on the definitely been talked about for quite a while, but for two completely different reasons.
Coming to the ring, the team of Cocktail and Owens. Here is the Bad Company.
He's taking issue with the sound rep here. This is not their usual song. Not happy about it. Usually being flanked by Pete Corvus, however, Pete Corvus took a few welts to the back and chest area thanks to the ECW icon, five-time world champion, Sandman.
It's not even our music. I don't know what the heck's going on tonight. But I just want everyone to know our opponents tonight are people we've already beaten. We beat them multiple times, and we're going to continue to do it because apparently they like punishment. So please, by all means, bitch.
That's right, they have faced each other before.
And let's see who their opponents are.
And to be fair, Bad Company have not been pinned or submitted this in quite some time. However, they have been disqualified quite a few times because they refuse to be beaten. Let's be honest. Whenever they feel that they're out-wrestled or outnumbered or outclassed, they pull out some shenanigans and get themselves disqualified so they don't have to suffer a loss. But tonight may be the night that all changes.
And now, coming to the ring, wrestling out of the Pine Valley, the team of the Hellraiser, Gabriel Harder, the Fear Monger, Matthew Owens. Here is the
with a black bandana, Gabriel Hodder with the white one, Primal Fear, trained by Damian Priest, QT Marshall, Jonathan Gresham. These two guys have been tearing up the New Jersey scene and beyond, and I think they have what it takes to put Bad Company away once and for all.
Absolutely, not just New Jersey. These guys have been making their way all up and down the Northeast Coast. I've seen them a ton in Pennsylvania, and they are absolutely breathtaking every time you see them. Like I said, built from the Pine Barrens, nothing safe and nothing holy comes out of those woods.
That would technically make this their home territory here. They would be. This is a home field advantage for Primal Fear.
Absolutely.
They're eight-time tag team champions. Hulk Gold all over the world. You may have seen them recently on Wrestling Open, coming up on PPW, Ring of Honor, AEW, Monster Factory Pro, MC, all over the place. I can go on and on, folks. And I could if I didn't stop myself.
Their resume is very strong.
Bad Company comes with a good lineage of training as well, trained by Jimmy Rave and Joe Gacy of the CZW. These guys are the first to show up, the last to leave, but unfortunately because of that, they feel like they run the place. They have more say as to what goes on.
Work for Shawn Michaels.
Looks like Hodder starting off against Kurt Bale. Call him a cheater already? I mean, he hasn't cheated, but it's a pretty safe bet.
Yeah, and this crowd obviously knows them very well.
And look at that, holding on to the hair to switch it around.
Watch him.
Kurt Bale knows how to hide it as well. Oh, wow.
We will be seeing the third member of Primal Fear later on tonight in singles action. They are a trios tag team who do like to use the free throw here.
Adrian Soriano going up against Tarzan Randall Wildman. But right now, well, I thought we were going to see Kurt Bale take some punishment, but he just turned right back around once again.
Come on, Gabriel.
And Hodder doing a little tit for tat. Lance a Hassan not happy about it.
Primal Fear will trying to extract that revenge win back from Bad Company. They've done their research.
Oh, catches him coming off the middle. Hotter, the powerhouse that he is. Omen in now. Honor to the corner. Omen. Huge kick. Find some more.
And a tag team, duo.
No! Big toss directly to the Ah, you love to see it.
Yeah, they didn't learn that just a couple weeks ago. These guys are they know each other very, very well.
5 seconds, bro. Come on.
Kurt Bale staying on the outside, taking a moment to recuperate. Replan, rethink their situation here. Honor now to the outside. Matthew, the legal man, comes in. Matchup, caught an elbow in the middle. Oh, come on. You know it was just a matter of time before that happened.
No one had a cheaper system.
Rough Jumbo there with his back turn trying to get Gabriel Honor back into his corner.
Come on, Roman.
Bad Company, and one thing they know how to do is how to manipulate the emotions of their opponents. They know how to get them so riled up that they give in and they start to come in. And that's when they work their magic.
Primal Fear kind of playing their game. They have a hair pull, return the hair pull back with more. That right there, if you're trying to cheat the same way they do, they know they're in your head.
Now Matthew Omen up to the middle. Oh no! Catches Omen, pushes him back in the wrong corner. Here comes Lance.
I say, cuts the ring hand. He almost threw him into his tag team partner for a cover.
Whoa, what? Thought we were going to see some acrobatic skills from Bad Company. Of course, after the pro, gets excited to see it. To get the old... Well, you know what it was. I don't need to say it.
The KMA.
Hold on. Omen fighting out.
He's out the back door.
Misses with a double clothesline. Here comes Hunter. Shoulder right into the midsection. Here Bale, an afterthought. Lance gets to the outside. Here comes Bale now. Misses with that clothesline and a back elbow.
Oh my God. I know football season's back, but he just folded him like a lawn chair.
Intensity pumping through his veins. Oh, here we go. Kurt Bale fights out, turns it around, short arm into a fireman's carry position. Oh, rolls through the DVD and Lance is tagged in. Springboard.
Wow, what a good tag team offense there. Only the two count. Dude, that guy was it.
They say what you want about Bad Company, and there's plenty to say about them, but they do know how to work very, very well in that ring. Open now with that spinning back elbow. Nice exploder out of the corner. And Lance all alone now. Here we go. The suffering. Could this be it? Oh, wait a minute.
His foot placed on the rope.
Clearly, Kurt Bale put it there, but there's nothing that we can do about it. It still got to the ropes. The count has been broken up, and you can hear the crowd letting us know how they feel about it.
He's getting brought in the hard way. Oh, never mind. That top rope.
Oh. This is that clothesline. Oh, rising knee strike for Kurt Bale. Oh.
Like that, Pete, the numbers are not even. 2-on-1 situation for Bad Company.
Standing switch. From Hunter. Oh, come on! I've never saw it! Lance is a legal man! You've got to be kidding me!
Your winners of the match from Bad Company!
And the streak continues, Anthony Blackmore.
He was trying to protect himself and protect the ref, and he caught a cramp in his quad.
Don't you start yet. Don't you start right now, Blackwell. You know what we saw. Don't start. Bad Company did their usual cheating ways. However, questionable they may be, they are also indeed effective. We can't take that away from them. Bad Company able to get yet another win on the Jersey scene, specifically here at Shore Star Wrestling. And we've got plenty more action to come, folks.
I think Hunter hurt his wrist. He's holding his wrist.
Yes, that could be it. Yes, the wrist. I'm talking the way home with you, Blackwell.